Hello everyone, I am Satish Kumar Evi, Assistant Professor, Department of Political Science, Theresian College, Mysore. In today's class, I am going to discuss with you, it's all about Constitution meaning, characteristics, and the significance of the Constitution. Now, we are going to discuss about the Constitution meaning and significance. The word Constitution is derived from the Latin word constitute. It means to establish, to frame, to organize, or to compose. In a simple form, the constitution can be called as a set of rules and regulations or procedure or the collections of the principles. Constitution is also called as the fundamental law of the land. It is also called as the rules of the state, instrument of government, and manifesto of the state. The constitution, it makes the relationship between the rulers and the ruled, between the people and between the representative. It also reflects the social, economical, and political changes of the country. Let us see some of the constitution definitions. The very first one, and the important one, is Aristotle, the father of political science. He defined the constitution as, the constitution is the way of life the state has chosen for itself. It means the way of life or the procedures or the rules through which the state or the society it has to go through. So this is the definition given by the Aristotle. Very similar to Aristotle, Gettel also, we try to define the constitution. According to Gettel, he said that fundamental principles that determine the forms of the state. So these are a few definitions about the constitution meaning. Let us see some of the characteristics of the constitution. The characteristics of the constitution, will be the common. Now I am not talking about the Indian constitution characteristics. Now I am talking about the constitution of the world. The countries which are having the constitution, then it will be the common characteristics of the constitution. The number one is the structure of the state. The structure of the state will be determined by the constitution. For example, in the case of India, India's state structure is to have secularism, sovereign, socialist, republic, and democratical country. So this is the structure of the state of India. So this structure will be well defined by the constitution. The next one is, it represents the heart and soul of the state. We all know what is the importance of the heart and soul for human being. Heart, it will pump the blood from top to bottom, and the soul, it is like the eternal energy which gives us the message to what to do or what not to do, what is right thing, what is wrong thing. So the same way, constitution, it also works like heart and soul. Without the constitution, it is impossible to imagine a democratical state or a country. So the rules and regulations, the principles, the procedures, everything will be well defined by the constitution. That's why it has been called as the heart and soul of the state. The other characteristics of the constitution is, it may be deliberate creation or gradual evolution. The constitution, it may be created purposefully. In case of India, India's constitution is created purposefully by the Constituent Assembly and Drafting Committee. The other characteristics of the constitution is the gradual evolution. For gradual evolution, the best example is England constitution, where the England constitution is not been created by any of the constituent assembly or by the drafting committee. The convention, the tradition of the country, it has been included into the constitution. So the England constitution is the best example for the gradual evolution. The next characteristics of the construction is, it may be in the written form or may be in unwritten. Written form, of course, the best example, India's constitution. We can also take the example of USA for best example of written constitution. In case of India, India's constitution has been written down by the Constituent Assembly. We took 2 years, 11 months and 18 days to complete our constitution work. For unwritten constitution, again we have to take the example of the England constitution. The England constitution is not being written, it's not in the form of written, it is in the form of unwritten. The other characteristics of the constitution is, it may be in one document or maybe in several documents. In one document, for example, India's constitution is in a book form, in a one document form. Anybody they can go and they can purchase the book, the document, and you can see and you can refer, you can study. But in case of several documents, the other characteristics of the constitution, we have to take the example of India, where the England constitution is not in one document form, it is in several documents. The some part of India's constitution is rest with the Buckingham Palace, with the monarchy, with monarchs, and the some part of the constitution of England is rest with political parties. The some part of the constitution of England is rest with the tradition and convention. So, by all this means, we can easily say that England constitution is not having one document form. The next characteristics of the constitution is, it is a growing organism. Constitution, it will get adjust with the circumstances. Any new law can be inserted, any old law can be deleted, excluded, any changes can be made, alteration can be made. So, because of all these things, easily we can say that the characteristics of the constitution is the growing organism. We'll go for the significance of the constitution. Why we need to study constitution, or why one country should have the constitution? What is the importance of the constitution? The number one is, it is very very essential for internal security and external security. For internal security, to protect the people, life and property, we need set of rules and regulations. For this, we need constitution for internal security. For external security, to protect the people of the country, or to protect the boundary, the territory of the country, to protect the people from external aggression. For all these things, we need a set of rules and regulations. We need a set of a structure of the state, the organs of the government. All these things will be determined by the constitution. So, because of this, we need constitution. The second significance of the constitution is to maintain law and order. Of course, to maintain law and order, we need constitution, as we discussed already while discussing about the meaning of the constitution, that constitution also called as the rule of the state, the fundamental law of the land. To maintain law and order, otherwise people will be uncontrollable if the country is not having a common rules and regulation. And also, the constitution is very very important even for the smooth running of the administration. It defines the responsibilities of the representative, the duties of the people, and all the three organs of the government, the powers and functions will be well defined. So because of all these things, we need constitution. The next significance of the constitution is, it outlines the goals of the state. The goal of the state, already we discussed in the case of India. India's goal is sovereign, socialist, secular, democratic and republic country. This is the goal of the state. It has been outlined through the constitution. So, to outline the goals of the state, we need constitution. We also need the constitution to regulate the behavior of the people. To have control over the behavior of the people, we need constitution. The people of the country, they should abide by the constitution. Violating of the constitution, rules and regulation will be result in the punishment. control or to have control over the people, we need a set of rules and regulations, and that is nothing but the constitution. The other significance of the constitution is to have control over the authority of the government. As we all know, we have three organs of the government: legislature, it makes law, it creates law, it enacts law, the executive, it will implement the law, and the judiciary, it will interpret the law. So legislature, it cannot create any kind of law. If within the jurisdiction of the constitution, law should be made by the legislature or by the parliament. And the executive, they cannot make any kind of policy, they cannot overrule the constitution. If it has been found, then judiciary, that is in case of Indian Supreme Court, it will interpret and it will go with the judicial review, and the law which have been created against the constitution or out of the constitution will be declared as null. The next significance of the constitution is to establish ruler and ruled relation. The ruler, the representative, and the ruled one, with the people. We both of us should have a very good relationship. Usually the politicians, once they will get elected for the legislature, usually the politicians are very famous to ignore the promises which have been made by them. But the ruled one, the people, will be having right to change our representative or to teach a lesson to the politician in the next election. So it is a very good sign for both the ruler and the ruled one to maintain very good relationship. The other relationship between the ruler and ruled one is both ruler and ruled, they have to work together because of the people, representative, have been elected, and they have to become the voice of the people in legislature, and they have to come up with the solution for their grievances. So the significance of the constitution, it makes the relationship between the ruler and the ruler. And the next significance of the constitution is it works like a guide to the future generation. For future generation, by studying the constitution, if there any loopholes are there, if the constitution is outdated, if something need to be changed, if something need to be altered, or any new law need to be included, or the existing law need to be excluded, then all these things, constitution is work like a guide to the future generation, which they give the information about the constitution, rules, regulations regarding fundamental duties and the fundamental the rights also. So because of all these things, we need